Hi, it's Kim Jamieson-Hirst of Chatterbox Quilts. I have a new toy in my studio that I've been playing with recently. It's the Janome Artistic Edge Digital Cutter, and Janome Canada has lent me this machine so I can get used to it and do some more videos to show you how to get used to it if you have one. And if you don't, all the features and why you will probably want to get one. Now, this particular model is a 15, which means it takes sheets that are 15 inches wide. There is a 12 as well, but the 15 is wireless. Yes, I can hook this one up to my laptop through my wireless connection, but if I want, I can also use the USB cable that comes with it. So the one thing that was quite a change for me when I got this cutter was that there are very few controls on it, and there's no screen or anything because you do everything on your laptop. So it comes with the Simple Cut software. That's your installation disk that you have. You'll put that into your computer, and then you're going to run everything that you're doing with the machine here is going to be run on your laptop. So you can choose the material you're going to be using, whether it's cardstock, whether it's fabric, leather, even thin metals, anything. You'll set that up. It'll set up the blade depth for you, and you'll change the size of things. Everything is done on your laptop. So that's a little bit of a change for me, but it's great because the Simple Cut software is very comprehensive and allows me to do all kinds of amazing things with this cutter. So let's talk a little bit about the cutter. I'm not going to go into a lot of features, but just a few things that I think are kind of cool. First off, we'll turn it on and it's going to try and look wirelessly to see if it can connect with my laptop, which isn't anywhere near here right now, so that's not going to happen, but you're going to see it flashing on and off for a bit. But it's very quiet, so you can't hear it very much. And it's pretty quiet when it cuts too. It's quieter than other cutters I've used. One of the features I think is kind of cool, when you open it up, this is where you're going to load your mats in. And I've got a couple of mats that come with it. They're still in their sleeves right now, but you would just put them in and load them up here. They're kind of a manual load system, so you can adjust them, put them exactly where you want, lock them into place. There is a light that's inside, quite bright lights across. You can see what you're doing. You can turn that on or off. And you also have the ability to adjust where it's going to cut the mat using these arrows here as well. There is a laser that is in the machine, and that will help you to line up exactly where you want the cutter to make those cuts for you. So when I first started with it, I cut a few shapes out here. So I've got a maple leaf. Let's see if you can see this better here. Let me move these out of the way. Okay, so I've got a maple leaf and a moon. Both of these are built-in designs in the software. My maple leaf is curling up a little bit. It has a sad story to tell you. When I started off with this, I like to do fusible web applique, and the software comes loaded with thousands of designs. So I could choose whatever I wanted to play with at first, and I chose the maple leaf because I'm Canadian. And because I like to do fusible web, I put the fusible webbing on the back. And then I put it on probably the wrong mat. I put it on the high tack adhesive mat. They're not kidding when they say high tack, it's stuck like crazy. Cut out, no problem at all, but when I went to take it off, most of the fusible web stayed stuck on the mat. So I was pulling this off, and that's why you see it curled. I could iron it down on some parchment paper or something, because it might still be a bit sticky on the back. But it cut beautifully, no problems at all cutting with it. And I learned how to take off fusible web off the mat if I had to, and that wasn't a problem either. I took an old credit card and I just scraped it all off. Then I used non-alcohol baby wipes to take off any residue, and the mat is just as tacky as it was originally. So that's a good learning step. You always make mistakes when you first start, but then you know what not to do in the future. So next time we went and we cut out this moon shape. Now this also has fusible web on the back, but I used the low tack mat and that worked very well. But a couple tips I'll tell you is, first off, if you are ironing fusible web on the back of these, you might want to leave the paper backing on. I had taken it off. You might want to leave the paper backing on when you cut. And also make sure that your fusible web is adhered very well to your fabric. I suspect mine maybe wasn't quite fused enough onto the fabric, and that's why it stuck on the sheet perhaps. So anyway, that's just a little bit of what I've started to do with this cutter. I'll be doing more videos to show you all the possibilities that are available with the cutter. And also I'll be using the cutter to cut out some shapes in the One World Quilt Along that I'm doing coming up in a little while here. So I'm very excited to use this machine, and I hope you'll come back again and check for future videos using the Janome Artistic Edge.